$4.5 billion. Gone in 30 seconds. This woman's cringe rap videos. They hid the biggest crypto heist in history. But here's the plot twist. Every move was tracked forever. Stick around. I'll reveal the three fatal mistakes that exposed them. And you'll see the exact transaction that brought down a billion-dollar empire. Think crypto is untraceable? Dead wrong. It creates the most detailed crime scene in history, one that never disappears. Poll. Is crypto really anonymous? Drop it in the comments. You'll see courtroom evidence proving digital money is more traceable than cash. But first, let's see how a cringe rapper almost pulled off the perfect digital crime. 2:30 a.m. Bitfinex, one of the world's biggest crypto exchanges, gets hit. In the next 30 seconds, hackers steal what's now worth over $4 billion. Back then, $72 million. Today, $4.5 billion. Because stealing crypto is easy. Spending it without getting caught, that's the real challenge. Meet Ilya Liechtenstein, tech entrepreneur, Heather Morgan, Forbes writer and rapper Razzlekhan, normal millennial couple, terrible rap lyrics. So, how do you actually spend stolen Bitcoin when every transaction is public forever? Poll. Is it easier to launder digital money or physical cash? Drop your guess in the comments. Money laundering started in laundromats, mixing dirty cash with clean. Crypto laundering, same three steps, but with a digital twist. Placement, getting dirty money into the system. Layering, creating confusion with complex transactions. Integration, making it look legit. Here's how Ilya and Heather did it. And why every move left digital fingerprints. Chain hopping, move funds from Bitcoin to Ethereum to Monero, then back, like switching getaway cars every few miles. Mixers, toss your Bitcoin into a digital blender like Tornado Cash, supposedly clean coins out. But is it really untraceable? Multiple wallets, hundreds of wallets, tiny transfers, always under the radar. Most systems flag big moves, not small ones. Real world conversion. Gold, gift cards, overpriced NFTs, crypto ATMs with fake IDs, all while Heather's posting as a blockchain expert. The irony is wild, but here's what they didn't count on. The same tech that made their crime possible would eventually expose them. Quiz. Which method was most effective and which one got them caught? Comment below. Plot twist. Crypto isn't a criminal's best friend. It's their worst nightmare. That anonymous tech? It's a digital confession booth, and every crime is written in ink that never fades. Every wallet has an address. Every transaction is on a public ledger. It's like leaving a diary of every financial move signed with a nickname, not your real name. The catch? Tech keeps getting smarter at connecting those nicknames to real people. By 2020, law enforcement's digital toolbox was next level. AI-powered companies like Chainalysis and TRM Labs scan over 50 blockchains at once, hunting for patterns, rapid wallet hops, round number transactions, mixing service fingerprints, links to known criminal addresses. It's like CSI for crypto, and the microscope gets sharper every year. But here's the real Achilles heel. Sooner or later, dirty crypto has to become spendable. Enter the exchanges. Every major exchange now demands KYC, real ID, address, bank account. These platforms run 24/7 monitoring. Suspicious moves flagged instantly. Law enforcement is looped in worldwide within minutes. The receiving wallet, fully verified, KYC compliant. Whose name? Ilya Liechtenstein. After years of high-tech laundering, they're busted by one slip. Now the FBI starts tugging at threads. Social media, bank records, spending habits, all under the microscope. What do they find? Two average people living a millionaire's life. Gold bars, luxury electronics, expensive travel. All traceable, all wildly out of sync with their reported income. And Heather? Still dropping cringe rap videos and writing Forbes crypto articles. The contrast is too much to ignore. Search warrants, seized devices. What do agents uncover? Everything. Detailed laundering playbooks, wallet backups, step-by-step instructions. Digital forensics tie their personal devices directly to the criminal wallets. The evidence? Ironclad. February 8th, 2022. 6 a.m., FBI storms in, arrests Ilya and Heather, and seizes billions in crypto hardware wallets. The result? Over $3.5 billion in Bitcoin recovered, the biggest financial seizure in DOJ history. This case flipped law enforcement on its head. Crypto crimes don't leave less evidence, they leave exponentially more. A traditional bank robbery, maybe some fingerprints, a grainy camera shot, crypto crime, thousands of permanent public analyzable data points. Forever. And as technology advances, the evidence only gets easier to read. What was invisible in 2016 is crystal clear in 2024. So, what's the real lesson from the rise and fall of Razzlekhan? Crypto laundering isn't about hiding transactions. It's about hiding connections. And those connections only get clearer with time. The blockchain is permanent evidence. What's invisible today will be obvious tomorrow. The human factor is always the weakest link. Fancy tech can't fix basic mistakes. As detection tools improve and regulations tighten, crypto laundering gets riskier by the day. But here's the upside. Understanding these systems isn't just about catching criminals. It's about protecting your digital future. The same blockchain that enabled this heist also makes finance more transparent and accountable for everyone. Your turn. Dive into the actual blockchain transactions using the links below. Try tracing the money yourself with the free tools I've listed in the description. Want to learn how to use these tools? And check out the FTX collapse using the same techniques. You won't believe what the blockchain reveals about those missing billions. Remember, the blockchain never lies, never forgets, and it's always watching. Stay curious, stay safe, and I'll see you in the next investigation.